Hey guys! A publisher called Zaka Workshop has contacted me and sent me their newly released book, Manga Artiscopic Marker Coloring Techniques. I'm collaborating with them and we're doing a giveaway for 2 free copies, so stay till the end to know the details of the giveaway. This book is actually originally in Japanese language, but they translated it so that non-Japanese speakers can get access to this source material. Actually, all of the books they've released so far are translated from Japanese, but so far this is their second anime drawing related book. To be honest, I was very excited when they contacted me regarding this because I've seen this book before in bookshops and I was very interested in getting it and trying it for myself, but I haven't gotten it yet, and getting it in English actually would be easier for me to understand. So yeah, in this video I'm gonna show you an overview of the book and show you my process of the trials I did while applying some of its tutorials and tell you about my opinion of it as you watch the process. So this book was originally done as a collaboration of 6 Japanese Copic Markers artists. It's divided into 4 chapters. The first chapter is about basic coloring methods. It starts with the very basics of how to use Copic Markers, as it talks about how to apply colors, how to mix colors, how to make gradations, as well as tips and tricks to follow when coloring to produce different results. It also talks about using complementary tools and goes into the topic of selecting proper paper for your Copic Markers illustrations. As for the second chapter, it goes into detailed explanations on how to color characters. Like, it first talks about coloring skin, eyes, hair, lips, sweat and tears. Then it goes on to talk about coloring clothes and discusses how to color different materials like fabric, fur, leather, frills. And these techniques are shown by different artists and you can get to learn different art styles and choose the one you prefer the most. The second chapter also talks about how to color accessories or additional items like candles, diamonds, pearls, and even some types of food. Then it talks about coloring nature and backgrounds, like it shows how to color different types of flowers, grass and wood, and how to color skies and water. As for the third chapter, it talks about fixing mistakes and growing your skills, so it offers tips on how to make corrections if you make a mistake in your drawing, and talks about some advanced techniques, and also discusses drawing Copic Markers on different surfaces. And finally, in the fourth and last chapter, it talks about the frequently asked questions of Copics and coloring. And in addition to that, throughout the book, it offers a lot of information on how to convert your artwork from analog to digital, and goes a little bit into how to make merch out of your Copic Markers artworks. Now that's about it when it comes to the contents of the book. Let me tell you now about my personal opinion. First of all, I did this quick trial of the things that mostly caught my attention and I felt intrigued to try. So I tried following the tutorials of coloring a rose, a pearl, a diamond, a cloud in the sky, and I drew Serena while applying the techniques for coloring the skin, eyes, hair, lips, and tears. So for me, this was a new style, especially the hair. I really loved the result, and I think I'm gonna use this method again the next time I do a Copic drawing. The nice thing about the book is that it lists all the colors used in every drawing, so that you know ahead of time. In case you want to apply a certain tutorial just like the book, you can plan to get those certain Copics and find out what color you're missing, and that way you can get a similar result. Personally for me, I didn't have every color mentioned in the tutorials I tried, so what I did was I substituted for similar colors, and the way I did that is that I looked at my Copic hex chart, so if I had a color missing, I look for the closest color and choose it based on that. By the way, I talked about the Copic hex chart in the tutorial video I made on how I choose Copic marker colors, so check that video if you want to know more about this chart. Now back to my trial. So yeah, I really enjoyed applying those tutorials. It made me use some colors that I rarely use and made me try some things I haven't tried before, like coloring a detailed gem like that and coloring a cloud. It's my first time drawing a proper sky on paper. But to be honest, I didn't really like the result I came up with, probably because the paper I used is not really good when it comes to blending colors of big difference. So yeah, I wasn't satisfied with that. But overall, I really liked the results I ended up with. I think that the explanations in the book were pretty good. They talk about each step in detail and tell you when to do the blending, when to switch the color, and so on. But personally, I think because it's just pictures and text, so they can't list every step they did. So sometimes you might find yourself needing to do some guessing in order to be able to follow the tutorial and get a result similar to what they got in the book. This was especially true for me when I did the gem coloring. I have never done gem coloring before, and honestly, I haven't studied them. I have absolutely no idea how they work. So I was just trying to exactly copy what I was seeing in the book, and the steps weren't enough. But of course, that goes on me. I think what the book is offering is the technique itself. So that personally, if I want to draw gems the next time, I can refer to this book and follow the steps while looking at my own reference photo in order to get it right. That's my only note about it, but regardless of that, the language in the book is very clear, very easy to understand, it's very informative, and I think it's suitable even for absolute beginners, people who don't have the slightest idea about Copic markers and how to use them. Like, it answers so many of the questions that you might take some time learning on the internet otherwise. It talks about Copic markers, the papers, and even talks about the Copic multiliners and using pencil colors, so I think it's pretty complete as a guide to help you start out and even improve your Copic coloring skills. I unfortunately haven't had the time to go through the whole book yet. I would have loved to go into each tutorial and applying every single step, but that needs a lot of time. So for now, I'm gonna keep it as a reference book, and every time I wanna do a Copic coloring, if I find a struggle in coloring a certain thing, then I'll definitely refer to it. Honestly speaking, I'm really happy there's a publisher out there willing to tap into the market of Japanese drawing books. There are literally countless books on drawing and coloring, whether digital Copics, pencil colors, different styles, but unfortunately they're all in Japanese and we haven't had many books translated so far. And I was thinking a few months ago, like, I wished someone would do the work and translate those books into English so that it becomes available to a wider audience. So yeah, I was very happy to know that such a publisher exists, and this being their second book really excites me because I'm hoping this is the start to a bigger thing. I hope they get into translating more and more books, because honestly, us anime artists already know that we really want to tap into this information and get to consume as much as possible. So thank you so much, Zaka Workshop, for doing this work, and I truly hope we'll see more translated Japanese anime drawing books. I'm really excited and looking forward to that. Now, as for where to buy this book, you can get this book from the Zaka Workshop website, or you can get your copy from Amazon. I'll put both links in the description box, so make sure to check it to know how to grab your copy. Now, Zaka Workshop has decided to collaborate with me and do a giveaway. They're offering 2 free copies for 2 lucky winners. Now, I'll be hosting the giveaway on my channel. Once I choose the winners, I'll send their contact information to Zaka Workshop and they will pick it up from there and contact the winners in order to arrange for shipping the book and delivering it to them. In order to join the giveaway, check the link in the description box. Do as many entries as you can, because the more entries you submit, the higher your chance will be of winning. The giveaway will end on June 27th. After it's done, I'll pick the winners and announce them on my community tab, so make sure to check it there. And if you're participating, please make sure you provide your proper contact info. And make sure to check your email after the giveaway is done, because if they don't hear from you within a week, then we're gonna choose a different winner. And you don't wanna miss your chance if you're lucky and you win the giveaway. So once again, please make sure to provide correct contact information and check your email regularly. And yeah, that leads me to conclude this video. Thank you so much for watching, and I wish you good luck.